Hello, welcome everybody to our 15-minute Sports Innovation Lab audience's coffee break. We're going to give it about 1 minute to allow everybody to fill up their coffee, sit down, enter the webinar, and then we will get started. So just give us 1 moment. Thank you so much for coming. Also, just to note, we do have a Q&A platform on this webinar, so don't hesitate if you have a question to go ahead and plop it in the Q&A. All right, good to see everyone coming in. This is going to be a quick one, so I'm only going to give it another 30 seconds to let some of those stragglers in. All right. All right. We are going to go ahead and get started. If you don't know me, my name is Gina Waldhorn. I'm the Chief Marketing Officer here at Sports Innovation Lab. And thank you all again for joining us for a quick 15-minute break, coffee break, that we're calling Winning Gold with Sports Innovation Lab Audiences. This is our deep dive into the Olympics and how you can activate to reach Olympic fans and take advantage of the cultural phenomena that is the Summer Olympics in just a few weeks. So let's get started. If you don't know Sports Innovation Lab, we are a fan intelligence, insights, and data company building the sports data cloud of the future. And everything we do is focused on helping organizations reach and acquire the fluid fan, the future fan, and the consumers that are going to help grow your business through data. And on today's 15 minutes, now we're down to 13. Don't worry, I'm not going to go over even by 30 seconds. We're going to go through three quick things. One, how do we define the Olympic fan? Two, who are some of the most valuable Olympic fan audiences that we think you should be targeting for success in your campaigns this summer? And then three, how do you get started? How can, by 3:30 today, you be activating and testing out some of our Olympic audiences? Just the click of a few buttons. So let's get started. One thing to note, today we are launching a new report called Winning Gold Digital Advertising Strategies for the 2024 Summer Olympics. And we're going to send a follow-up email from this webinar giving you all a copy of this report. So I'm going to touch on a lot of different topics. Don't worry, we deep dive into all of these topics in the report that will be in your inbox later today. So let's get started. Everyone's talking about the Olympics. Everyone's talking about designing campaigns to reach the Olympic fans, but who is the Olympic fan? Sports Innovation Lab, we have a very specific, solid perspective on this. Olympic fans are fluid fans. They play sports. They're active. They participate. Their love of international sports is broad. They love cricket and handball and rugby and sports from all over the globe that they're excited to see finally take the center stage in the Olympics. They're also leaning into more emerging sports, and we'll talk about some of those like surfing and skateboarding and free climbing. Huge women's sports fans, and obviously you know that has a special place in Sports Innovation Lab's hearts. They're also obsessed with the athletes, the record breakers. This is where you see the best of the best. So you have to think about the Olympic fan through the lens of the athletes they love, and so much more. The Olympics is truly a place where culture collides with sports fandom. So it's important not to pigeonhole Olympics into, well, they're the bandwagon fans who tune in for the 2 weeks during the summer. They are much more than that, and they express their Olympic fandom in different points in between the summer and the winter Olympics. And it's important that we understand through data who those people are so we can find them. And the problem we set out to solve and what we've done with our Olympic audiences that I'm going to bring you through today is that when you try to go buy an Olympic fan today on programmatic platforms, you're probably getting something like this. They've watched some Olympics on NBC or Peacock, or maybe they've got old cookies from the actual Olympic channels, and maybe they follow some Olympic athletes. You've got some broad demographic data. This is who you're gonna target, the Olympic fan. That's not good enough for Sports Innovation Lab, and that's not gonna deliver for your campaigns. This is what we call an Olympic fan. Through our unique data set, we're able to see what leagues they love, those international sports leagues, what teams they follow, whether they have memberships in NGBs and Olympic organizations, Olympic athlete shops, Olympic team shops that they're spending on, what platforms they're streaming on, and specifically, who is that individual? Is it a man? Is it a woman? How old are they? And really paint a broader picture. But I started off saying that Olympic fans are much more than just your kind of traditional Olympic sports lovers. It's also important to understand who they are outside of just that love of sport with what other brands they buy. So this is the complete picture of who an Olympic fan is when Sports Innovation Lab designs an Olympic fan audience. I not only know that they love La Liga and their football, but they're heavy travelers. They prefer Delta. And when they land, they're going straight for Dunkin'. And when it comes to cleaning and household goods, they care about sustainable brands and they're subscribed to the Grove Collaborative. These are all important aspects of who the Olympic fan is so that you can design the right audience. Now, how do I know that? How do we create that robust picture? It's through our sports data cloud, which includes all of the different data sets that you're seeing on your screen now. It's got that deterministic, observational, transactional data that is much more powerful than cookie-based data, which is what we showed kind of a lot of Olympic audiences are created on based on cookies and inferred behavior. This is transactional data for over 80 million US consumers. We've gone ahead and we've tagged more than 7,000 unique sports and entertainment, including Olympic merchants that are unique to our data set. And we're able to attribute and append additional important data flags onto that data to truly build a robust audience. This is just a sample of some of the kinds of categories of vendors that are used when we design an Olympic audience. So I mentioned those 39 specific NGBs are in our data, Team USA shops, Olympic athlete shops, national team stores. If they're actually going and they're buying a tip for the Olympics in Paris, we've got them in our data set and so much more. And that's going to allow you to create not just an Olympics fan, but an Olympics gymnastics fan who's also a frequent air traveler, or an international Olympic sports fan who also loves to shop at Home Depot or Lowe's or Home Improvement. These are the quality audiences that we think are going to be the differentiators for those campaigns that succeed. So now I'm going to take you very quickly. What are the high value Olympic communities we think it makes the most sense to focus on this summer? The first, women's sports, because this is the first ever gender equal Olympics. We will have the same amount of female athletes as male athletes competing. And this is driving a whole lot of new women's sports fans to tune into the Olympics this year. They're also high value, more likely to buy sustainable brands, more likely to spend on charitable giving. This is a high disposable income where more than half of Olympic women's sports fans are more likely to be luxury shoppers. And I'm not just talking about women, because we found that 89% of men's sports fans were also women's sports fans. And in previous data, we've shown it's a lot closer to 50-50. So how do you activate women's sports fans who are also Olympic fans? You go into our audiences, you select our Olympics women's sports fans, and then you reach out to us to customize so you can create an Olympic women's sports fan who also spends on Peloton, or an Olympic women's sports fan that loves to buy from Swatch or Movement or Fossil, or is a gamer. So the ability to customize our syndicated audiences is really what's going to help meet a lot of your campaign objectives. Our second focus area in high value sports communities, emerging sports. Breaking is making its debut at the Paris Olympics. Surfing is back in Tahiti for the second year. And we know that surf brought a lot of new fans to surf community. In fact, looking at from 2021 to 2022, when Tokyo debuted surfing, we saw the increase in number of surf fans in our surf community go up by 20%. We are also welcoming skateboarding, free climbing. Younger fans are leaning into these emerging sports. So we've got a set of emerging sports audiences on our syndicated platform, and we're also able to customize based on brand objectives. So let's go out and get an Olympic emerging sports fan. Maybe it's surfing, climbing, cricket, esports, who are also maybe insurance purchasers of specific brands like Allstate or State Farm or Nationwide. Or maybe you're going after a bettor, where we know the highest value bettor is a bettor who bets both online and in a casino. We've got them and can create that unique sports betting Olympic audience for you. And then off the back of emerging sports, another high value community we'd love to activate is youth sports. Because youth sports fans have been more likely to stream or travel important categories around the Olympics. We have youth sports registration platforms, youth sports leagues, youth sports gear, combined with an Olympic fan parameter to create an Olympic sports youth fan audience. And if they love to travel, maybe this is key to add on. They also spend with alternative accommodations like VRBO or Airbnb. We also know that they're high streamers. So maybe you also want to target those folks who stream Sling and Netflix and Hulu Live. And again, because emerging and youth sports are targeting that younger Gen Z, Gen Alpha, we've got a dedicated Gen Z community. They're purchasing Discord and Patreon and Fenty. And it's a great way to reach them through that cultural lens of the Olympics. All right, so we've got about 4 minutes left. So how do you actually activate these audiences? So right now, after this seminar, this webinar, you can go ahead and log into LiveRamp or any one of our partners, Trade Desk, Google DV360. We'll show you all those partners in a minute. These are our available syndicated audience for purchase today. Everything from those who purchase on Team USA to Olympic fans who also care about equestrian, golf, ping pong. And like I mentioned, you can take any one of these syndicated audiences and you can push it wherever is accepting of addressable media. LiveRamp, Trade Desk, Viant, Google DV360, Basis. And please take note that 30% of NBC and Peacock's Olympic inventory this summer will be programmatic and available to purchase on the Trade Desk. So we can take any of these audiences. You can find them on any of these platforms, put them on out of home, CTV, streaming, display, Meta, Pinterest, Peacock, and we'd be happy to customize with any of those additional brand buying or category buying parameters so they really achieve those campaign objectives. Again, we're really eager to have you tell us how they're working out for you, because so far they've been outperforming all of the cookie-based audiences, lifting conversion by almost 20 times for some of our clients because they're deterministic, because they're observational, because we are the only company who has tagged all of these thousands of Olympic and sports-specific merchants and brands in our data set. This is a very unique set of Olympic audiences for you today. So we're coming up on the end of the webinar. You're going to get an email from us. We'll have a recording of everything I just brought you through. We're going to go ahead and plop in the chat right now a list of those syndicated audiences. So it's as easy as going to one of these platforms and copy and pasting, or just searching Sports Innovation Lab in the provider or in the audience data store search bar. You can also reach out to us, send Jennifer an email, jennifer.polino@sportsilab.com. We'll stick this in the chat. You can reach out to me, gina@sportsilab.com, audiences@sportsilab.com. That's where we take your custom request. We'll build you a custom audience, push it to your preferred programmatic platform, and get you started right away. So we've got everything you need. If you haven't started working on Olympics yet, don't worry. It's not too late. That's why we've done all the hard work for you. And finally, do not miss these kind of quick 15-minute coffee breaks or something we're going to continue to do if you found it valuable. Coming up next will be some of our fall favorites, back to school, football, and youth sports. And because we like to keep our promise, for our agency, for our brand, for our programmatic media buyers who have joined us today, we have a really fast, it's like 3 or 4 questions poll that we just put up on the screen. Please answer those questions. Plop in your email and we're going to send you $5 to Starbucks, which you can go buy today or save it and buy the coffee and then come back for our next 15-minute coffee break. I'm going to check the Q&A. Did we get one answered question? Oh, great. Someone answered the question. So look at that, 314. Is there any last question I'd be happy to answer? Otherwise, fill out the survey. We'll leave it open for another minute. We'll send you your $5 coffee. We'll get to that new winning gold digital strategies for the 2024 Summer Olympics report, and reach out to Jennifer Polino or audiences@sportsilab.com, and we'll get you up and running, before the end of the day. Thank you everybody so much for joining. Yes, right now we have a question. Is your data US only? Our data is on 80 million US consumers, the transactional data. However, we've got thousands of international vendors represented in that data. So if they're spending on Juventus or La Liga or any of those NGBs or international sports, and it's on their credit or debit or our transactional data, we can see it. All right. Thanks, everyone. Don't forget to get your coffee, and we'll see you on the next coffee break. Have a great rest of your week.